I have a daughter who's 15 and she's very active. And I can't go to the chorus concerts and to her performances that she does with Color Guard because I'm typically sick, or I can't sit, you know, in bleachers because my foot is so big that, you know, the bleachers only give you a small space and so the boot won't fit. And
it's okay. I understand.
Even though she understands, it's hard looking at her face and telling her that I can't, you know, make it to different events because mommy doesn't feel well.
I completely get that. I just want to kind of get a feel of when you first started to have the symptoms and what you've done so far in trying to help yourself.
I didn't get diagnosed fully with lymphedema until I was a teenager. And by that time, it was just so out of control that the wrapping and stuff wasn't working. They're telling me they're going to have to amputate the leg.
Okay.
And so I had a newborn child, and there's just no way that I can live, you know, with my leg amputated.
Right.
It just kept getting worse. And so now it just drains constantly. I've been draining for years now. I mean, it's just drained so bad that I have wounds.
Wow. Are you able to show me the wound today, or is it too much so you don't have to redress your whole leg today?
You want to see it?
Yeah, I want to see like how much it's draining from the dressing.
You see that?
Yeah, I see it. How long ago did you change your dressing already?
This morning.
This morning? Okay. Do you typically change the dressing once a day or twice a day? How many times a day do you change it?
This dressing right here, I just change it once a day.
Okay.
Because with medical supplies, I don't have enough medical supplies to constantly change it.
Constantly change it, okay. And what color, the color on the bandage of the drainage look yellow?
Yes.
Okay, does it smell like sweet at all? I know that's kind of a weird
acronym. No, it doesn't smell sweet or anything.
Okay, that's what I was getting at, just making sure that it doesn't smell infected. Tiffany, do you have someone there that can help move the camera so I can see your leg and your foot?
Yes, I have my friend Candace.
Okay, hi Candace.
Hi.
Candace, I wanna see like how bad the wound is or how big it is. Bend down the camera so I can see the leg and the foot. Wow, yeah, that's a big wound there. So it does look like there's parts of the wound that are healing with the discoloration of the skin, that like pink skin there.
This one right here just actually recently started.
I see that the whole area is a little macerated and drained. When you have that amount of retained fluid in your limb, your skin definitely changes.
Right.
It's almost like melted and bubbling over because it's just that moist inside of the body. And it's like several like waves of the skin, you know?
Right.
Like almost as if you were in water and your fingers got wrinkled. That's how it looks.
And then the ankle part down there.
So can you go down towards the foot, Candace? And then you could get me a visual of her toes.
I've had issues with the toenails. I actually had the big toenail removed because the pressure so much on there and it kept getting infected. So they actually removed that.
Okay. So you have multiple wounds right around where your ankle is.
Right.
And that's where you're draining the most, yeah?
This whole area is drains.
The whole area is actively draining. Okay. Tiffany, can you run your finger across the bottom of your foot? What does it feel like? Does it feel like wet? Is there like
wet?
It feels wet. Okay.
Yeah. You want to see how wet this chair is just from that little bit of time we're in there?
Oh, wow. Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of drainage. Okay. Thanks for showing me your leg, Tiffany. That was a lot of information that's totally necessary. So thank you so much. So just based off of this call and everything that I've seen, here's what I think is going on. Tiffany, you have really severe lymphedema. The first thing we have to do is get rid of these wounds. In order to clear your wounds, we have to control the draining. So I need you to get silver alginate wraps to control and sop up the fluid. And then I need to get you in the office so that I can help you get a compression device called a FlexiTouch. I need the FlexiTouch to massage and get rid of the fluid on a daily basis.
Okay.
Basically, it pumps from the foot up. That way the fluid has somewhere to go. We want to get down to a diameter of the foot and then the leg, and we can make it at least more manageable.
Okay.
my whole objective is to just see what newer technology and conservative therapy can do before we move to a more radical solution of amputation. So I'm hopeful.
Thank you. It really means a lot to me that you're willing to.
Absolutely.
That you're willing to help me.
You want to make the best decision that's going to make you the best mom for your daughter.
That's the only reason I fight so hard is because of her, and every decision I make is because of her.
Absolutely. We're going to try our best to do what's best for you. And then I need to get you in the office. We're going to need to see each other in person.
Right. this is very exciting.
Okay. Bye. So anytime you have a leg that looks like this and you have the predisposition for infection, you can absolutely be at risk for losing your leg.
My next patient is Nate. Nate has these crazy growths on the bottom of his foot. What's up, Nate? My name's Dr. Schaefer.
Dr. Schaefer, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So what's going on, man? I just saw all your videos and your pictures. You know, it looks like you're walking around on rocks. I mean, that's how painful it looks like.
Yeah, it is. It's a lot of pressure for sure. All the men on my dad's side of the family, it goes back as far as I know.
So I'm sure they've passed down their treatments and their tricks throughout the years.
Yeah.
All right, well, look, what I would like to see is the feet. If you could just possibly pop one of those feet up so I could get a good look, you know, live here. Ah, man, yeah. That's good. I see it. And Nate, they're hard. You could probably pound on that like a rock, right? Wow. Let me see your left foot, Nate. All right. That one looks a little worse, is it?
Yeah, because this one, it started growing up here too.
All right, Nate, so when you squeeze them and stuff, like what is the consistency of that?
So the initial layer is very rough and hard. Underneath that is, it's a little bit more moist, a little bit more soft.
Sure.
I would say, as gross as this sounds, it has a consistency of like Parmesan cheese. It traps moisture, right. And the rough part about that is that it will leave a smell in the shoes that won't go away.
So you have that legit funk going on.
Yeah, it's pretty legit.
Can you show me a little bit of what your routine is like?
Absolutely. So in my cabinets here, I have a couple of things. First are these box cutters that you can just buy at the store.
Oh, wow.
They're really useful for getting big chunks off. So I keep these and, you know, do them as necessary with that. This is like a cheese grater, kind of. It's okay. Like more for like the finishing touches, like and grating it down real good.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And you just, you know, rub it on your foot and the flakes come off.
Oh, Nate, stop shaving your feet. Now look, the stuff you have right there, I definitely understand using that. But, you know, going to a doctor and having that safely taken care of is the way to do it. So just so you know.
Okay. I've just been using what I can, you know.
All right, Nate, so we got to get you treated. Have you ever heard of something that's called genodermatosis?
Genodermatosis, no.
All right. Genodermatosis is a condition that's hereditary, okay? Once you have something like that, the calluses are going to continue to build up. That skin and keratin is going to grow layer upon layer, like triple the speed of a normal callus. It's very rare. I personally have never, you know, dealt with this in my practice. Unfortunately, there isn't a magic pill or cure that I can give you to just like fix this. The treatment for this is going to be something that's going to make it manageable and something that you're going to be able to keep up with. What I want to do for you is shave down those calluses with my 15 blade to a base layer. Once we get those calluses shaved down, you're going to get a cocktail of creams, and it's going to be up to you to apply these every day to make this condition very manageable. And that's going to really help you out so these calluses aren't crazy and you can really control them.
That would be the best.
The next step is seeing you in my office. If you have any questions, you let me know, you give me a call, but we'll be seeing each other soon once quarantine lifts.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much.
All right, Nate, nice meeting, man.
See you.